Welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serbi. Now today I'm going to talk about the extraordinary case of the slain businessman, Bonnie Francis. For those of you who are not aware, Bonnie Francis was a quite popular businessman, right? He was the CEO of B&D Trawling. Some of you might know them, right? They're very active, right? Well known in the fishery industry. Bonnie Francis lost his life in summer 2011. Right. He was leaving home, right, on his way to work, I assume, one morning, right, him and his family, and man draw down upon him and take him life. Now, you might have heard how the police solved this case. The showpiece evidence was actually some GPS tracking, when people were scratching their head, GPS tracking, right? But here's the thing, it got much bigger than that, and a matter of fact, the GPS tracking is not, right, the key decider in terms of what turned the case. Right, I'm going to tell you a single event, right, that took place while they were taking the life of Bonnie Francis. That, in my opinion, that is what make it able for the police and even get the GPS and anything there. Right, so four men were originally, right, arrested. Yeah, I think to yourself, four, but only two man means I just get sentenced. Yes, two men. I've been sentenced to you. One of them, right, is a man by the name of Carlos Batista. And if you're thinking, that name doesn't sound very traditional, it's not a stereotypical Jamaican name, well, he's not from Jamaica, right? He's from the Dominican Republic, right? Now, Batista used to be in business with Bonnie Francis. He used to work for Bonnie Francis, but then he ended up switch and go work for the next fisheries company. But don't worry, we'll get into that. The next man, George Gardner, 37-year-old computer technician. And yes, you heard me right, a computer technician. Gone on apps, right, for taking man life. Contract healing. Now, he was the one, right, that ended up played a role in the pivotal moment, right, that led to the case getting solved, in my opinion, or the moment that, you know, started the snowball effect. But there were two other individuals. Yes. One was Sheldon Watson. And another man who completely beat the case, because you know it got ready. If a 4 or 5 are under there, you still need, you can bring a case against everybody. But the last person, Newton Welsh, he beat the case because they couldn't find nothing upon him. The witness said, right, they couldn't spot him face, because in the moments leading up to the hit, one man that ride one on the bike, right, and I scope out the yard and I wait until Bonnie Francis left. But because him that wear the helmet, right, the witness couldn't positively identify him, right, so him end up bust the case. So Batista, Gardner, and Sheldon Watson, right, are the men who really face the judgment. So as I said before, Batista did use the work for Bonnie Francis, right, and according to the courts, after Batista leave B&D, he end up go work, right, for a direct rival named DYC, right, and it would him end up in a court, right, civil matter. Bonnie Francis win, right, the judgment. He end up win the case. Him appeal it, right, and Bonnie Francis still, right, they have the upper hand, right. In other words, him like go win the appeal too. Say no, say no, money have to go pay up or whatever. Big loss is coming. Remind of Batista yesterday. But Batista used to be working with Bonnie Francis, now he's working for the other side. So Batista stands for lose now, right? Because he's now Bonnie Francis' rival. Remind of a business people we're talking about, you know. Businessman we're talking about, you know. We're not, I'm telling all the time, say, Jamaica is a place where even your favorite lawyer, your favorite judge, right, your favorite CEO, money upon people head all the time, right? When they swarm to beaches out on them Monday, right? A regular, your favorite, right, businessman and entrepreneur or executive or lawyer, even all your pastor, right? A problem with man go win money against them and then decide to say, you know what, this not working, right? But I put a hit on him head and that's what going on. So anyway, Batista now start plot. Batista go rent car. get up the man them to carry out the cruel acts. But here's the thing. You know, say, rental car always have up on it. Tracking. So Batista go rent car now, get up. Right? I stake out the man yard. One of them dip on bike. Right? Up and down the morning. Right? I look for see when time Bonnie Francis have go left out. Right? That's the one that end up was the case. When them see Bonnie Francis have come, of course, as you know, them attack the man and him end up losing his life. But while they were shooting at Bonnie Francis, the pivotal moment occurred, in my opinion. You see, Bonnie Francis' son was armed and realized they might attack his father. So now the son start defending the father, and the son and Gardner end up in a shootout. Gardner now start on fool and run up and down, chucking a car, because women telling all the time, what 87s don't want? A shootout. They don't come from a shootout. Right? So the son now engaged them. Gardner jumping at the car, might try to take out himself, and the son shoot up the car. This was the pivotal moment. Because you see, the rounds him going at the car, right, later on, helped make it easier for the police in their investigations. Right? Because, remember, once them understands, all right, there was an exchange, round for you go meet car, so now them can start move around the place, check which car do this and which car do this, which car buy part, so the police end up catch up with the car, right? Because they don't know the incident took place in Queensway, right? So you know them place there, if a neighbor knows you, some camera will catch you or whatever. So they end up get in touch, right? Or they end up find out which car it was. But by then, the man then change the parts on the car. Which part of the rounds them go? Right. Them go change the parts on the car. When the police then catch up with them, the driver, Watson, the way him frightened, so them get catch, he may not all car, the police go show them when them dump the old parts them, when them take off of the car. Right. So me tell you something, my favorite, the reason why enough of them things are going is because man, they expect to get catch, you know. Because as soon as the pressure catch them on ya, them fall up like a chair, you know. Right? Same care the police, them go show them all this part, them dump the parts and them thing, right? So now them have the parts, the rounds them, right? Can I say it clearly get shut up? Right? Them have the car. Go find out, say, the car is a rental. Go find out, say, a Batista rent the car. Right? And then here come, right, the Hollywood part. This is the part of people, I say boy, JCF investigators really do well. Because once they find out the car, a rental, alright? Rental, of tracking, we could check back the GPS. And the GPS show, right, that the car was at Batista Yard, right? This is the man from Dominican Republic. He did a female yard in the days leading up to the attack, right? And it was also at Bonnie Francis' place, right? So when she say, evidence get tight now. So when she say, man, no problem now. Because I you rent the car, Batista, and this car was at your yard, and now the same GPS tracking shows that the car was at Bonnie Francis' yard, Pandidi, right? And they have a full map of where the car go, left, right, center, all over Jamaica. Right? You see a rental car, Bonnie with Batista, you know. Right, go take out. Help sink them. Yeah. Talk about poetic justice. Now, the driver. You see him right there, I'm telling you, so end up I'll show the police them which part. Him throw the parts and them thing there. He was offered a plea bargain. Now, when he get offered a plea bargain, when he come out in the news and get offered a plea bargain, there wasn't any mention of if him take it. So, as I've been, because a long time, yeah. You know, even though I'm checking upon this case. Will I wonder if he take it or not? Well, guess what? Guess how much time the driver get? Him get sentenced from last year, December 10th. So him get sentenced to them 2 years now. Him get sentenced from last year, December 10th. You know why? Because he took a plea, right? And him plead guilty to accessory after the fact. Right? You know if him sentenced? 2 years imprisonment, which was suspended, right, with supervision. 2 years suspended sentence. I don't know, it look like say, right, whatever I give them, it look like say the info so sweet that them say, you know what, brother, we don't even want you to do a D in a G. Your info too sweet. Right. We are talking about water commission thing or so. Right. When a man, right, who take part in a murder, the driver at that. Right. Driver normally get at least 10 years. Right. If you take part in it. The driver do some serious time. If now get not 30 years, but the driver do 10 decent years. 2 years imprisonment, was suspended. So now the question of did, right, him take the plea deal, now we know so that get answered, because that charger, the only way you get for plea for them charger is when the justice system say, you know what, thank you for the job you've done. So it look like say he gets some honey and lime, right, to make sure say everything alright to him truth, right, and you know, he surely tell him where they want you, right, and he may not get a good deal, excellent deal. Now, what made this case so extraordinary is not just the fact, say, right? It was a high profile individual who lost his life, but the type of people them would I get dig up. Right? Bonnie Francis lost his life in Queensway, but Hal Millsboro also get raid. Uptown place I get dig up, computer get take out. People, you know, them Millsboro people, them lie down in their bed comfortable next to them here. Greater tear off, big police presence, big military presence. That was most unusual, right? Especially for people. If, I'm assuming people know where Millsboro is. Right? Millsboro is one of the places where Jamaicans consider to be uptown. Right, you know, it's a more affluent neighborhood. So nobody really expect to see a JDF and JCF ops there. So, right? And they surely raided it. Big raid go on. Right? But because the trial takes so long, people as they see it, it get by you because Carlos Batista, right, and the money link with them money and the money have their money, so nothing can come out of that, right, in the case I'll get that right. Just like with the Stephen Carswell case. Sometimes people say him there's no way him can go to jail, him too rich, him too uptown. Tell people all the time. As long as a witness can stand up in a court, right, case will drop a man will get found guilty. Witnesses make or break trials. Any case you want to think of, right, where somebody should, right, get sick because, you know, all the evidence point towards them, right, but them still bust the case, it means there's something going on with the witness. Either the witness never turn up, or the witness get buyout, right, or the witness did extra shaky or something like that. Right. In this case, the witnesses did deliver. Right. I'll miss it because evidence was so solid. Because remember, even though the son shoot up the car, that in itself wasn't enough, right, for seeing everybody, right, because then you still have to prove, say, right, Gardner do this, you still have to prove, say, Batista do this, and the money can afford the best lawyer money can buy. But between the GPS tracking of the car and the witnesses that came forward, right, it was a slam dunk. And the JCF investigators deserve a lot of credit, the DPP and our team deserve a lot of credit, right. This was a major, right, success for them based on who they might go up against. Right. But I think people are overlooking the fact that if the son wasn't a private citizen who was armed and could defend himself, right, and could have an exchange with the man, then the car wouldn't get shut up. Right. And then they couldn't trace back this and piece back JPS and all them things. So in my opinion, that's really, right, what triggered the snowball effect. So that show you, say, when people, right, have the means to defend themselves, right, even if they don't take the life of the attacker, right, they can still end up make something go on in a court. Because otherwise, they may let us go for Bonnie Francis, take the man life, drive away, and go on about their business. The car getting the whole lip around them, right, and the police them even tracing back to which part them go buy the parts, right, because as they know, once them link up with the driver and the driver start break and tell him, sorry, right, this or that, and then we go over here, so, and then the money I fix it, that make it easier for them get, right, Batista, right, remember, you know, him them really want, you know, Batista and the shooter. That is why they were more willing to give the driver a plea. In them case, the driver is normally the man who will get the plea. Right? 9 times out of 10, especially if him never actually pulled the trigger. So, before I finish the video, I want to say this. Bonnie Francis' case is one of many. Enough time when you see businessman lose them life. In them circumstances, it's another businessman. Get rid of them. Remember, when it comes down to badness, most 87's victims are linked to them in terms of proximity. Right? You live down the lane, you live in the community across the way, right? You come from the end zone, so with them and them and war, that's the majority of what we call industry's badness. When somebody go a Queensway for man, right, you know, so that's targeted. But this will show you how easy it is to man lose them life, because remember the case in Spanish Town, right, with Corey Goat Boss and Janice? Well, they might say, oh, well, you know, that only happened because Janice, you know, she wasn't, you know, very well off, and this is how people just take advantage. Well, see, apparently, even whether you want to be CEO of the company, it can still happen to you too. Man just put money on your head, and they just keep upping the price until the hitman say, yeah. But the odds are great against 87s who try to carry out certain apps in a quote-unquote uptown community, because for one, enough of them place the full of camera, right, as we saw with the Simone Collymore incident. Not only that, enough of the host them, right, the people them have the means to defend themselves, you get them, I try to say. Plus them have them German Shepherd, and them have them Akita, right, and some dog way cost more than people Yang Yang bike, right, and I like how me have my one little mongrel, you know, cost me much, right, people have dog way, people have all 6 dog in them yard, and dog them, if you sell the dog them, you can buy a car, some deer dog, right, people are running with them yard, I get them yard, so 87s normally go up on certain apps and, you know, end too well for them. Because they just have more to overcome. See, when time I run in a Charmian Rattray place, because I just have the smallest home, and they just kick on the door and go in. I saw 87's rolling, you know, when they in their own neighborhood and their own community, they just kick on the door, right, tear out the window, right, because they're not going to hold up the defenses. But when time they start going to certain communities now, they have to go deal with wall, and then go over the wall, they have to go deal with the German Shepherd. And then get past the German Shepherd, they have to go deal with, right, the fancy door and all kind of things. So if you're 87, I like them kind of upset, but cause, right, the money might nice them still take it on. But just know, say, Jamaica is a place where even the people them way have money, even the people them way quote unquote successful, and you say, well, you know, them not have the, right, them not need for, so if you better believe some man resort to violence just as fast. Just as fast, you know. But I think that buying a man like some money attached to morality. That's the mistake making Jamaican. Like some money equals morality. Oh well, him don't reach charity, so why me the want? You're frightened for no. Okay. And sometimes the money they might give up, and not even the money will go hurt them, you know. Sometimes the court case. I don't know how much Bonnie Francis was supposed to get, but sometimes the court case would all be around 5 million Jamaican dollars. Money where they use, they spend that pantry of their mistress in a 1 month. But if they lose it in a court, they rather pay 87, right? If you get rid of you, that feels to give you 5 million. Jamaica is a serious place. A serious, serious place. But let's say Bonnie Francis family get some justice. Unfortunately, not many families in Jamaica are so fortunate. We know why it happened, let me say. The fact that they could have challenged 87 and shoot up the car, right, played a major role. I just wish more civilians, more citizens had the means to defend themselves, right? And more cases would go like this, because either 87 not gonna pick up around, at least the car of them coming and pick up around, or they might just lose them life straight out. But majority of the citizens are sitting ducks. FLA back in the news again. Businessman convicted, a foreign convicted out of much things on his name. We were saying he have multiple weapons. The same FLA will turn down people for the simplest of things. FLA will tell people, say, alright, even though you have no criminal background, I run all the checks and people say you have sound mind and would us feel like say, because you know them are shit enough. You know, show we say, just cut it out, you want a food. People, when FLA turn on them, I'm telling them, say, I mean, I tell people who not get turned on for, like say, you know, you don't have no criminal background, right? And like that. When FLA turn on the people, them, because no food not run. Because we are sister, man who have all kind of track record, still I get all that. All that links, food I run. Just like anything else. But who are squeezed, who are greased over palms, right? I get the break. Because some people make up their minds to them now pee out. Right? No bribe to nobody, forget no weapon. And that's the way it should be. People shouldn't have to dip in the pocket. And I give them no food, and I squeeze them on nothing. Forget the right to protect themselves and their family. But nobody, no matter how much you talk about FLA, right, all them do is release some big PR statement, right, and then nothing happened afterwards. Now, care how much scandal hit FLA, right, it look like right now them TFLA, they need to change them name from FLA, right, to TLA. The Teflon Licensing Authority, because them Teflon, nothing to stick by FLA. Now, Kira come out about them. What I'm telling you, say, the amount of 87 known scammers, all kind of man, right, have license for him in Jamaica. Right, and Carlton can't get none. But the man them agrees to ride palms. Right. Man, we have all dope people on their name. I walk up and down with the means to protect themselves. So, just I do this video because people are more fascinated by the GPS tracking and all that. No, this start with the fox, the sun. Could have challenged them on them and shoot up the car. And that is what triggered off things. Really end up with a conviction. Anyway. Let me let this one, I just have to know. Patreon Squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know. More life. Vulture Squad, stay circling. Bless.